Basal gyrase reflex is a chemo reflex that is mediated through nervous vagus and causes triad of symptoms, its apnea, bradycardia, and hypotension. This reflex is caused by chemical stimulation of primarily ventricular baroreceptors, basically it's cardiopulmonary baroreceptors that are localized mostly in the inferior and posterior walls of the left ventricle, and is important, and also arterial baroreceptors that are localized in carotid sinus and aortic arch. And there is a logical question. Baroreceptors are mechanoreceptors that are usually activated by stretching. How chemical substances can elicit baroreflex response? And it was determined that, for example, in case of arterial baroreceptors, chemical substances can activate the same stretch-sensitive transient receptor potential canonical channels that are usually activated by high blood pressure. So basically, in this case, chemical substances imitate stretching. Now about the reflex pathway. When chemical substances appear in the blood, they activate baroreceptors that are localized in the inferior walls of the left ventricle. From baroreceptors, signal in afferent unmyelinated C fibers is going through nervous vagus to brainstem, to nucleus tractus solitarius, that directs the activity of cardiovascular centers. It inhibits vasoconstrictor and cardiac accelerator center, and stimulates cardiac decelerator center. And this results in massive increase in parasympathetic nervous system activity and decrease in sympathetic nervous system tone. Also, these chemical substances stimulate arterial baroreceptors that send this stimulation as high blood pressure. They also transmit signal to nucleus tractus solitarius that stimulate parasympathetic nervous system activity and inhibit sympathetic nervous system tone. And it's possibly the reason why in basal gyrase reflex, compensatory sympathetic nervous system activation by arterial baroreceptors does not occur. This increase in parasympathetic nervous system activity first of all causes massive vasodilation that results in decrease in systemic vascular resistance, and also through nervous vagus it inhibits sinoatrial node. This causes decrease in heart rate, so it's a mechanism of bradycardia. And recall that blood pressure is equal to cardiac output on systemic vascular resistance, and cardiac output is equal to stroke volume on heart rate. So decrease in heart rate causes decrease in cardiac output. So heart pumps less blood volume per minute, and decreased systemic vascular resistance both cause substantial decrease in blood pressure. So it's a mechanism of hypertension. The mechanism of apnea is different and in the same time quite similar to the mechanism of cardiovascular system. In the lungs, there are also C unmyelinated endings that called pulmonary C fiber receptors, also called G receptors or juxtacapillary receptors. They are localized within alveolar walls and are innervated by fibers of nervous vagus. And the intravenous or intracoronary administration of the same chemicals can cause stimulation of G receptors that through nervous vagus transmit signal to nucleus tractus solitarius that directs the activity of respiratory centers, and this results in apnea. Also, some physiologists refer the occurrence of this triad of symptoms in case of IV injection to a pulmonary chemoreflex, and only occurrence of symptoms after intracoronary injection they consider as basal gyrase reflex. So this subject is still under discussion. Also, this reflex causes another clinical symptom that is not included into a triad, is decreased level of consciousness. Because pronounced hypotension can cause decrease in cerebral perfusion, and because brain tissue is very sensitive to ischemia, even minimal decrease in cerebral perfusion manifests with clinical symptoms. If ischemia persists only for a few seconds, it results in dizziness or faintness. But if it lasts for more than 10 seconds, it can cause syncope, which basically is a mechanism of vasovagal syncope that we will discuss further.